Americans that wear shoes inside their homes. Why? Saves time so I don't have to put my shoes back on again when I get in bed. I didn't used to. And then I lived for a period of time in a part of the country where wolf spiders are common. I now have a pair of sandals just for wearing in the house. And I always wear them as here. The thought of stepping on a 2-inch spider in the dark barefoot makes me want to detach my legs like one of those lizards that can shed their tails. As a fellow American, I too wonder the same thing when I see movies and the characters have their shoes on their beds in around the house. In a movie, they're not going to take the time to remove their shoes. Screen time is valuable. Mr. Rogers disagrees and he's never wrong. I have a kitchen floor that somehow creates broken glass out of nothing. I don't break glasses in there, but I still often find broken glass no matter how much I clean. Are we all gonna ignore the fact that this guy is finding glass of shards that come from nowhere? I'd be concerned someone else is there unless you're somewhat new there. She is probably bringing them in on her shoes because of wearing the shoes in the house. The glass comes out onto the floor. Ob steps on it, then decides they have to wear shoes because of the spontaneous generation of glass on the floor. Because you walk around with your shoes in the goes, you bring in the glass. I found warehouse slippers protects my feet more so than socks. Me and family have specific shoes for inside the house. They are not to leave the house and we are all happier. My parents wear shoes in the house. I've asked them and their answer is basically that it's inconvenient to take shoes off and put them on all the time. They must suffer that inconvenience when they visit my house. In Sweden, we get killed by our parents if we have shoes inside. It's the second leading cause of death in Sweden behind COVID-19. I live in a house with other people. The one owns the house and is a complete slob who doesn't clean anything. I wear my shoes until I get to my room, which is the only clean one in the house. I have a dog. He can't take his paws off, so it seems pointless to worry so much about taking my shoes off. I have 3 young kids and 2 dogs, all 5 of whom are constantly in and out of the house. I do my best to keep the house clean, but fact of the matter is I'd probably have to spend 2 hours a day cleaning to keep the floors clean. We don't sit on the floor. We don't eat on the floor. I don't fold laundry on the floor. So why should I care if it's not perfectly clean? Someday the dogs will go over the rainbow bridge and the kids will be old enough that they're not playing in the grass all the time. At that point I'll probably get nicer flooring and furniture and dishes and we'll probably enforce no shoes in the house, but for now it's just not a hill I'm willing to die on. Yup, 2 dogs, 2 cats, and a dirty basement I'm in and out of. Plus my 3-year-old that's constantly outside. If I'm not barefoot with dirty feet, I'm usually in my shit kickers or boots working on something. There's a reason I shower before bed and scrub myself. I have a lot of pets and hardwood floors. If I don't, my feet will get too dirty. This seems to be a big one. Anyone with pets, especially pets who go in and out the house a lot, is going to want shoes. I grew up in a farmhouse with hard, cold floors and dogs. Wearing shoes was normal. 1. I have house slides that I wear when my feet are tired. 2. I don't consciously take my shoes off at any point. Sometimes I'll take them off when I get home. Sometimes I'll wear them up to my bedroom monsieur. It's just convenient, which is the answer you already knew. So, is Op really just asking out of a sense of judgment? Trust me. Aside from actual dirt, your house is just as dirty as the bottom of your shoes. Good thing I shower daily and don't lick the floor. Yeah, exactly, it's a cultural difference. It shouldn't be a big deal, but some people like to get on their high horse about how gross it is. After my arch in my right foot collapsed, my podiatrist said I should never walk barefoot again if I could help it. More comfortable for me. I go outside a lot too. Don't have to keep taking them off and putting them on. I wear house shoes, slippers in the house when it gets cold to keep my feet warm, monsieur, but we all take our regular shoes off at the door to keep dirt low. Why shouldn't I? I clean floors like any other surface in the house. We don't impose the no-shoe thing on our friends either. It takes 2 minutes to hit the floor with Murphy's oil soap. I spend more time rinsing dishes after a dinner party. Total non-issue that some people insist on making an issue. And I'm a clean freak. I buy cleaners in bulk to save money. Same here. All the floors are either hardwood or synthetic carpet that's super easy to clean. We had a Sharpie pen break open and spill permanent ink all over. Came right out using nothing more than a damp rag. Can't even tell where it happened now. Mere shoes aren't going to do any harm to our floors. So why would I care? If leaving them on is convenient, then leave them on. NBD. Because why the hell not? I wear my slippers all day because I can't stand dirt on my feet. I think slippers should not count. I am not American, but I wear slippers all the time at home too. It protects your feet from cold and dirt. Makes your movement slightly faster. Makes you taller and you don't smell your goddamn feet from across the country. Usually cause I'm about to go right back outside. Also cause I'm a dirty savage. Arch support. My feet are fucked up. Why do people worry so much about what we do in our own homes? The most underrated response in this whole thread. In my house. If I'm planning on going back outside again within 5 minutes, it's not worth the effort to take my shoes off. When I'm someone else's house, it must just be an American thing. But the act of taking off your shoes means you are comfortable and plan to stay a while. Maybe someone doesn't want me in their house for very long. It would just increase tension when I took my shoes off, and lead to an awkward 10 seconds of putting them back on when we left. When going to someone's house for the first time, I always keep my shoes on unless they tell me where to put my shoes. However, if I'm going to be visiting my brother for the day, I know to take my shoes off on the front porch and then come in. Because it's always been commonplace for me. I grew up with a lot of pets. I have bad plantar fasciitis and it is painful to be on my feet for any extended period of time. Without specialized shoes for extra support. What's it to y'all? Seriously, get the fuck over it. I prefer to wear shoes most of the time. I can feel productive with them on. I don't have to create this ritual each time I go in and out. I clean and sweep regularly. I don't put my shoes on the couch or in bed. My toes get cold easily. Walking around in slippers all day makes me feel like I'm never quite awake. I don't have to make my guests feel weird when they come over by having to walk around in their socks or slippers that other people have worn. I can choose to wear shoes that have some laces or other aesthetics and not just slip-ons. Seriously, why do people care what others wear in their own homes? I have bad feet from sports injuries compounded by arthritis. Wearing comfortable shoes that support my joints means less pain and more productivity in the space where I spend most of my time now. They're dedicated house shoes. The ones I wear outside stay in the garage. Love how this is aimed at Americans as if nobody else in the world can wear shoes. I specify Americans because it's a practice that is relatively common there. And people in Europe and Asia find it odd. I am European and I can confirm. That's definitely not the case. At least not throughout all of Europe. I don't think I know anyone who takes off their shoes in their house till they're in their bedroom. And it's considered rude to take off your shoes in someone else's house unless you're close. When I was a child, we had to ask permission to take off our shoes when we were visiting someone. UK, taking off your shoes kind of indicates that you're staying a long time, so maybe it was seen as a bit presumptuous, rude. I'm not sure. Or maybe it's because of stinky feet, lol. Scorpions in the house. Don't want to step on one without shoes. Why are they in your house? Exclamation mark. Exclamation mark. Exclamation mark. Arizona? How can you ever relax? Because traditionally up until after the World Wars, many homes, especially the poorer ones, still had dirt floors. So the concept of taking shoes off never took hold. But me personally, I have a pair of indoor shoes and a pair of outdoor shoes. You have a site for that? The percentage of U.S. homes that had dirt floors during World War II had to have been very small. Sometimes I keep shoes on in the house. I have some foot issues that require insoles, supports, and cushioning for my heel. When my heel isn't acting up, I sometimes go without shoes, sometimes I don't. If my shoes are filthy, I leave them at the door. If they're mildly dusty, I scrub them at the doormat and enter. If they're clean, I just walk in. It's not a big deal because I sweep the floor daily. I vacuum the floors twice a week and I mop the floors at least once a week. I also wash my shoes pretty regularly. I live in Southern California, so the doors and windows are wide open and we spend much of our time going in and out of the house. Really, the outside is just an extension of the house. Everybody's commenting on how much fecal matter I'm tracking into the house, but honestly, who the hell is stepping in that much shit? It's obviously an overstatement trying to make their case, but the world is not that much cleaner inside your house than outside. Outside your house you have insects and dust and dirt. Inside your house you have insects and dust and dirt and dust mites, skin cells, food crumbs from eating and cooking in. Believe it or not, fecal matter from your own bathroom is here. There is no real clean. There is only sort of clean, and you can still have that wearing shoes in the house. Daughter doesn't like wearing shoes and often won't all weekend. Going in and out of the house at all times. If think shoes are dirty, you should see the bottom of kids' feet. My husband calls those summer feet. As soon as the ground warms up, my shoes come off and stay off. My feet end up very stained before it has been warm long. Yes, I'm mostly barefoot now until at least September. Am I supposed to put house shoes on when I come inside? I hate shoes. Always have. As a person from India, I can confirm that this is very surprising to outsiders. Once I told my grandmother that foreigners wear their shoes even on their bed, and my grandma straight up rejected what I said. I was like, it's in a lot of movies, there's gotta be some truth to it. Here we never wear shoes except for when we go outside. But too, most of the people wear slippers, and by most I mean 95%. So shoes are something that kind of became inherited culture here. I do not know a single person that would wear their shoes on their bed. I'm sure there are some people who do. But this is something that really only happens on TV and in movies. People in America don't wear shoes to bed. Maybe if they're on something and pass out. But that's not a cultural thing. And never has been. Where do people wear their shoes in bed? Movies. As an American, one can tell you the vast majority of us do not wear shoes to bed or on furniture. Not all, but most do not. I went to a wedding at a temple last year. The pile of shoes outside was huge. Some people didn't know they would be removing their shoes and felt a little naked. I think Americans consider their shoes to be more of a fashion accessory than Indians. If we more unilaterally took them off, even when entering churches or temples, we would see them differently. Thank you so much for watching and have a good day.